Hello everyone, welcome to Fedeline Villota YouTube channel, where godliness is taught to practice in every area of our lives, for this is the only way transformation will happen in our society. Before I start, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Praise the name of the Lord, amen. And welcome to our worship today. Not only that, Happy Mother's Day. Amen. Happy Mother's Day sa lahat ng mga nanay. Amen. Okay, Happy Mother's Day. So I'd like to bring your attention this morning to Isaiah 49, verse 10, 16, and Isaiah 66, verse 13. Okay, I'll be reading the scripture. So I encourage everyone to open your Bible to Isaiah 49, 15, 16 and Isaiah 66:13. So I'd like also to encourage lahat ng mga nasa online, you can also open your Bible and join us in reading the Word of God. Isaiah 49:15 says, "Can a mother forget the baby at her breast or have no compassion on the child she has born? Though she may forget, I will not forget you. Verse 16, see, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Your walls are ever before me." And Isaiah 66:13 says, "As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you, and you will be comforted over Jerusalem." Amen. Lord, just bless your word in our midst today. I pray, O God, that you just speak to us, Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay, this morning we are going to learn how God, ito maraming scripture sa Bible, but I'd like to just focus the scripture in Isaiah 49:15-16 and Isaiah 66:13, where God compares himself to a character of a mother. Okay. So the Bible says, sabi ni God, can a mother forget the baby she born? Actually, a mother cannot, even the experience of giving birth. I remember I have four boys, and every one of them, di ko makalimutan kung paano ko sila pinanganak. The experience I have with my eldest son, it was a twilight, twilight yung pagpanganak, para kang tulog. And very hard because I labored always 12 hours. When I say labored, the pain of giving birth, you are going to, I experienced it for more than 12 hours. Every time nanganganak ako, 12 hours talaga, more than that, ang labor pains. Pag nasa labor pain, you don't know saan ang hawakan mo, sa ngipin ba, sa noo mo ba, o saan. Basta masakit, cannot be compared. Hindi, incomparable yung sakit. So I labored siguro ka sa eldest ko from 1 o'clock in the morning until 5 p.m. in the afternoon. Ang tagal, at ang hirap-hirap. But the joy of a mother, kung ang nakakamangha, paglabas na, wala na, nakalimutan mo na lahat yung pain. Another one, yung pangalawa ko naman, ang hirap din. Kasi sabi ng nagpapaanak sa akin, sabi niya, ay, ano kaya nangyari? Bakit ang daming blood na lumalabas na buo-buo? Sabi ko, Lord, maawa ka talaga, manganak ako ng normal. And after mga 12 hours then, nanganak din ako. The other one, yung pangatlo, mas matagal. Si Ram yun. Pinaakyat pa ako ng doctor mga 1,000 times sa hagdan. Ang tagal talaga, akyat baba sa hagdan. Para ma-open yung... Ang nakakatawa, pagka next day pa ako ng anak, ang hirap nun. And another experience, pang-apat, yun medyo may edad na, mas mahirap yun. Dahil, kailangan i-induce dahil lumalaki na siya. Hindi siya dapat magsobra pa. Hindi na siya pwedeng hindi pa ipanganak ng araw na 'yon kasi lumalaki na. Hindi ko naintindihan. Pero ang hirap noon. Dahil ang pag-induce, nakabuka kakat parang more than 12 hours. Ang sakit talaga ng mga, alam nyo, yung paa ko, wala na akong lakas nung nakapanganak ako. And, grabe. I cannot imagine the pain of giving birth. Grabe talaga. That is the experience or an experience of a mother. That's why God compares himself to a mother who gave birth. Can a mother forget the baby? You cannot. Kasi lahat parang hanggang ngayon, my eldest is already 26 and I can still remember even the detail of how I gave birth to him. Kaya ang Bible, the Bible says, can a mother forget her children? No. Kaya kinumparan ni God, ni Lord, ang kanyang character doon sa character ng mother. Kasi hindi makalimutan ng nanay ang kanyang mga anak. Amen? Kahit anong mangyari, the mother cannot forget her children. Amen? So the same experience, how God loves us so much that He compared that love to a love of a mother, sabi niya, kahit nga makalimutan ng nanay ang kanyang mga anak, I will never forget you. But as a mother, kahit anong mangyari, a mother cannot forget her child. Lahat yon, ako as a mother, I can remember all the detail when I gave birth to my children. Ganon kahirap, mga anak. That's why the Bible says, can a mother forget the baby? So number one point is, a mother cannot forget her children. That's why I encourage the children to be grateful to their mother. And I want to give a warning. I can observe, ang daming mga bata ngayon o mga anak ngayon na sumasagot sa nanay nila. Ang sinasabi pa naman nila, bakit? Sinabi ko ba sa iyo na anak mo ako? Ganun pa ang sagot-sagot ng mga bata ngayon, mga high schoolers. I can hear that. But I want to give you a warning in Isaiah 45:10. Isaiah 45:10, listen to this. Lahat kayong mga high schoolers and mga college students, sabi ng Bible, Isaiah 45:10, woe to him who says to his father, what have you begotten? Or to his mother, what have you brought to birth? Nakakatakot pala yun, mga high school and mga bata. Yung sinasabihan nyo yung nanay at tatay nyo, bakit? Sinabi ko ba sa inyo na i-anak mo ako? Naririnig ko yan palagi. Remember that is a curse. Sabi dito sa Bible, woe to him. Kasi alam nyo, ang kaming mga magulang, sometimes kami ni Pastor Charlie, it took us around 3 years to pray to have a children. 3 taon pa kami na nanalangin na bigyan kami ni Lord ng anak. Ang iba naman, 10 taon na, wala pa rin. Iba naman, wala talaga. That's why you cannot say to your parents, bakit? Sinabi ko ba na anak mo ako? Kaya I give you warning dahil the Bible is declaring curse sa mga nagsasabi ng ganito. Ha, it is a warning to all of us here this morning. Huwag niyong sabihan ng mga magulang niyo, pag magalit kayo sa kanila, ang galing-galing niyo sumagot, at sasabihan niyo sila na, bakit sinabi ko ba na i-anak mo ako? The Bible says, woe to him who says to his father, what have you begotten? Or to his mother, what have you brought to birth? Siguro it's time for you to repent. Ngayong panahon, magsisi kayo, bakit the Bible is declaring a curse? Woe. It's a curse to those people or to those people who are saying that to their parents or to their mother. I can hear that, mga high schoolers. Ang galing talaga sumagot sa mga nanay. At sinasabihan ko kayo, kawawa kayo. Repent now. Bakit sabi ng Ephesians 6, 2 and 3? Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment meant with a promise that it may go well with you and may enjoy life, long life on earth. That's why this is a warning today, mga bata, mga high schoolers, mga college students, all to all of us. Never say again to your parents, bakit sinabi ko bang anak mo ako? Ganon palagi ang mga sinasabi nila ngayon. Pag i-rebuke mo yung mga bata ngayon, yung mga high schoolers o mga college, pag i-rebuke ngayon ang mga anak, i-correct, sasagot agad, bakit sinabi ko bang anak mo ako? And I pray this morning, it's time for you to repent because the Bible is giving us the warning. Woe to him! Curse! Ibig sabihin ng woe, curse. Sumpa! Ano ba sa Tagalog? Sumpa ba yon? Sa Bisaya is tunglo. Kaya, this morning, I'd like to encourage each one of us to ask forgiveness to your parents if you have ever said it to them in front of them when you are being rebuked or being corrected, because it is a curse. So the Bible is saying this morning, a mother cannot forget. Amen? And because a mother cannot forget, God himself compared that character to himself. I will never forget you, God says. Amen? He cannot forget his children. When we belong to God, sabi niya dito, I have engraved you on the palms of my hands. Yun ang promise ni Lord. I have, imagine ka, nakatattoo ka doon sa kamay ng Diyos. Your walls are ever before me, sabi ni Lord. How much more also a mother? Me as a mother, I have said to you, I cannot forget my children, even the very time I gave birth to them. That's why you are so special. You are special to a mother and also very special to the Lord God Almighty. Amen? And the second point I'd like to bring you is, a mother comforts her child. Ang mama naman talaga lang ang makakomfort. I'm mahilig din ako manood ng mga palabas, ano ba yun, mga Korean novela. And I've seen one whose mother is, she find ways and means na kasi hinahabol sila ng mga tao to kill them. She finds ways and means na talagang mabuhay yung anak niya. And I remember a testimony during the Japanese time that a mother really suffered so hard throughout her life because during the war, sabi ng kanyang kwento, umiiyak ng umiiyak yung anak niya. And in order for them to be saved, they have to tinakpan ng unan yung ang baby niya para hindi marinig, and that baby died. And that mother suffered throughout her life with that memory. Imagine ka? Kasi a mother is talagang, a mother really love her children. And the second point is, a mother comforts her child. Alam nyo, kahit ang nanay wala ng pera, walang makain yan, she will find ways and means to feed her children. Amen? Ganun daw din ang sabi ni Lord. So I will comfort you. In fact, the Bible says in John 14:26, Jesus said, but the Counselor, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you all things and will remind you of everything I have said to you. So the Holy Spirit was sent in order to comfort and to teach the children of God. The same also in comparison with the mother. A mother comforts her child. Amen? Alam nyo, ang nanay, hahanapin yung lahat na paraan upang mabuhay yung mga anak niya. I'm not saying negative thing to some father, but sometimes when the father is so pasaway in the house as a husband, the mother will really sacrifice. Hindi siya lalayas kahit ang gusto niya nang lumayas dahil hindi niya nakayanin yung attitude ng kanyang asawa. But the mother will stay for the sake of her children. Throughout my stay here in Pasig for around 28 years, I only met, as a teacher, as a school principal, I only met one father na siya nag-alaga ng anak niya, and because the mother left them. Isa lang yun out of my 28 years of being a teacher and a principal here in this place. Imagine ka, one in a million talaga yung mga nanay. That's why the second point is a mother comforts her child. Ang nanay talaga, by all means. Kaya, we have to be very, what is the application this morning? We have to honor and respect our mother. Amen? Love your mother. Kung nagalit ka sa kanya, keep your mouth shut because it's a curse to say something to your mother, even to your parents. Naintindihan ninyo? Kasi ngayon, parang as a school principal, as a teacher, as a mother, I can see ang galing talaga sumagot sa mga magulang. And I encourage you this morning to keep your mouth shut because you are cursing yourself when you say something to your parents, to your father and mother. And the last thing, the application is, listen to your mother. You can read that throughout the Proverbs, the book of Proverbs, you can read that, that God is teaching us to listen to your mother, makinig kayo. Because only throughout my life here, being in my 50 pluses, wala akong nakitang nanay na tinuruan niya ng masama ang kanyang anak. Always, she always suffers for the good of her children. And so, this morning, the Lord bless all the mothers of the around the world. And I pray that as this the word of God this morning is a comparison of how God loves us so much. God compared himself to a mother. He used that the example of the love of a mother and his love as God. And also he used the comfort of a mother that gave or is giving to her children. How God comforts also his people. I pray this morning we love and love our parents, our mother, and also we love more God. Because sabi niya, I have engraved you in the palms of my hands, God said. But also to the mother, mothers engraved their children in their hearts so that they will never forget you. Amen? Lord, thank you for the word this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you for mothers around the world. And also thank you for our mothers. Lord, I declare blessing to all the mothers around the world today. And also, Lord, forgive us many times when we are being corrected, when we are being rebuked by our mother, even by our parents. Lord, we say something in which the Word of God says it's a curse, it's a woe. And this morning we repent, oh God, just forgive us. Because the Bible says, honor your father and mother so that, for this is the only promise, this only commandment that has a promise of long life so that everything may go well with you. Lord, thank you for your word this morning. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I pray the 2 points that we have this morning, that you will never forget us as a mother and you will comfort us as a mother. Thank you, Father in heaven. All the glory and honor and thanksgiving belongs to you alone. Amen.
Thank you for watching. Don't forget that Matthew 11:28, Jesus Christ is inviting all who are weary and burdened to come to him, for he will give you rest. Invite him today, saying, invite him into your heart, saying, Lord Jesus, I invite you to be the Lord and Savior of my life. I believe that you were risen from the dead and you are alive forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. God bless us all.